Evening, everybody. Welcome to the club. Love to get your thoughts as ever tonight, particularly on, well, that England performance, and how could a side go out of the World Cup because of receiving too many yellow cards? Doesn't seem right to me.
A penny for the thoughts of Gareth Bale right now. Left out of the Champions League final starting 11 last year. The same, of course, as we know now, has happened this time around. What does his future hold?
Is there anything you can say to, anything you can say about Loris Karius right now?
Yeah, afternoon all, welcome to Old Trafford, the biggest game in world football, an estimated global audience of around 700 million. The problem of late is that this match has been anything but entertaining to watch.
Just finally from me, you've spoken about your disapproval of your schedule over these last 2 weeks. Have you been able to speak to anybody from the Football Association, from the Premier League about it?
No. And we'll leave you with Matt Critchley and Michael Gregg.
Boys. Yes, Trevor Francis Bingo, I think, is what we're playing tonight. How long will Trevor join us for? Nobody knows. But so much to talk about over the course of the next hour. Mickey, how are we going to fit it all in?
I don't really know.
No, it's we don't have any idea. It's a complete movable feast.
Antonio, did your players show the character that you were looking for tonight against difficult opponents in difficult conditions after the result against West Ham? Was this exactly what you needed from your team?
Phil, as a player, you're still playing. Are you entirely happy with VAR in your head about what might go to the review? Do you understand it?
I don't.
No.
And for me, it's the wrong tournament to trial it in.
This club has been through some difficult times against Barcelona over the last 3 years. Is this mentally a big moment for the team and Manchester City?
Could it get any better? Well, it did. They qualified for the knockout stages alongside Athletic Bilbao, disposing of the likes of Hertha Berlin. Now they face one of the biggest names on the continent in the round of 32. In this footballing outpost, this has been a truly remarkable journey. I want to introduce you to a man who I respect more than just about anybody else in the world right now. This is Speedo Mick. And he's got Everton on his bottom.
Look at you, you can see the fear in your eyes just talking about him. He never lost against him, by the way.
No,
he's very proud of that stat.
I didn't. I'm proud of
that. As a one-to-one, when he's running at you with pace, what's that like?
Evening, everybody. Anfield, under the lights, a European night, pouring with rain. We have it all tonight. Some of us even have an umbrella.
Welcome to Huddersfield and two sides that need some Premier League points this evening. It was all looking very rosy for Liverpool a couple of weeks ago when they beat Manchester City, but then consecutive defeats, firstly down at Swansea and then the FA Cup against West Bromwich Albion, and all of a sudden one or two people are questioning Jurgen Klopp once again. As for Huddersfield, no wins now in six games for them. They've lost their last three in the league, just 2 points above the relegation zone.
Surprising team news here tonight. Marouane Fellaini comes into the starting lineup. We didn't expect Paul Pogba to return, but Scott McTominay drops out. Fellaini starts. The other change from the game here against Liverpool at the weekend is Jesse Lingard in for Juan Mata.
Sorry, just to confirm, you'd never taken a penalty in your professional career.
Actually, I didn't even practice it because everybody thinks always the German they are practicing.
Yeah, yeah.
We never did it before the games.
That's staggering.
Not one time.
And you took a penalty in the semi-final.